came into the travel industry by chance, and when I got started with travel, someone called me and he asked me, "Do you do mice?" Hearing that, I just told to myself, "Have I heard it right? Or you know, is this person out of his mind? What makes him think when I am in travel that I am in the business of catching mice?" But I guess I soon realized it was my sheer ignorance. What really mice means is very different from what it means in travel industry. So like the way I discovered mice in travel, and I discovered travel by chance, there is yet another person who entered travel industry by chance some 20 years ago. While she was attending the dermatology conference. Yes, you've heard that right. The dermatology conference. Her name is Tanuja Pandey. Let me explain. This person is a postgraduate in German interpretation. And she was present in one of this conference as an interpretator for German. And that's when she discovered her passion for mice, for travel industry. Since then, she's not looked back. She's been in travel. And guess what? She's also known the cat of travel, and the mice love her. So ladies and gentlemen, please join me. Welcome the cat of the travel industry, and mice love this cat very much. Tanuja, over to you.
Oh well. Hi everybody. Okay, he's just given me a new name. I didn't know that. I'm the cat of the mice industry. Since this is a thought leadership meet, you know, I wanted to first actually do some thank you to some thought leaders who have shaped me, and that's one of the reasons I stand here is the way they guided me in my early career. One of them is Mr. Gopi, sir. Thank you. And I think Ashish has left, but yes, thanks to him as well. So since we are talking about thought leadership, at some point of time, the thoughts were channelized by these ex-bosses. This slide is especially for you, Vishal. Okay.
So, not more advanced.
Yeah, so you know, I mean, when we talk about mice, I mean, there are many, when I talk to people across different industries, and they ask me, "What do you do?" And I say, "I'm into mice. I'm a mice professional." So they're like, "What?" So then I have to explain, of course, the meaning of mice. But in a way, this, you know, somewhere this analogy, as I look at all this, you know, we mice professionals in this industry, I think we treat all the corporate houses as the cat, and we think who is going to bell that cat. So, you know, let me welcome my fellow mice guys onto the panel. Naveen Tui, a friend, a competitor, sit outside the same client's offices for hours together. Can we have the next? Mr. Deepak Jagtiani, welcome. Then Mr. Bharat Jain, I would like you on the stage, please. And Mr. Arun Hattangdi. Welcome, sir. So, hi, everybody.
Hello.
Yeah, and we all are in the same space of MICE, the vertical of meetings, incentives, conferences. E for events or exhibitions, as you want to take it. The one thing I wanted to first open the discussion with is that, do you think that everybody and anybody in the tourism industry can do mice? This question is open. Do you think it is a very specialist field, a focused vertical, or anybody can just come in and say that, yes, we do mice? Naveen, would you like to take that on first?
Thank you, Tanuja. To some extent, I agree that it's a field which required certain kinds of skills. Because the mindset is very important to do any kind of job or a business. Therefore, some people who have this kind of skills find themselves out of place if you put them for some other kind of a job. For example, there are people who are interested in events business. FE is a very strong and important component. If you interact with them, you will find they have some different kind of skills, different kind of thought process. They look up to the business very differently. Same way, people who are into conferencing business have a very different kind of skills and understanding of a subject. So in my opinion, yes, it's a specialized field. Even in certain countries, you have to be a certified meeting planner certification before entering into this business. If it is not, then why these countries and even our own country in many universities are offering separate subjects, separate diplomas in this particular field?
Yeah, Mr. Arun, your take on this?
Yeah, I would like to directly answer your question. MICE needs specialization, and there's a lot of hard work is needed to understand the entire gamut of services that you provide. It is not just ticketing, it is not just airline booking or visa. It is a combination of all the services, right from the basic thing till the end, including the events and conferences. So each and every corporate approaches various travel houses or whatever it is because of that particular specialization. If it were to be just ticket or hotel, most of the companies have their in-house or ticketing agency. Still they go to a MICE operator because it's a specialization, and a lot of things need to be understood. You need to have a couple of rounds of discussion with the corporate, or even if you are doing an exhibition or a trade fair, meeting the particular corporate or an individual, explaining to him the whole services that need to be put together, explaining about the cost and the whole thing. So combination of various services and understanding exactly what are the needs of the corporate is very important. So MICE is a combination of almost all the travel services that we hear about it, and I feel it's not a cup of tea for each and everybody to get into.
Yeah, so basically it is a lot of detailing, a lot of logistics that goes into this. So I think my friends who do events and exhibitions, they would also want to share their view on this particular point.
It's very simple, like we nowadays, at least, you have so many event institutes also which also teach travel. Everyone, I mean, it's not everyone's cup of tea definitely to get into travel, because there's a lot of hard work, logistics that go into it. But personal point of view, from even from an events and a travel point of view that I've seen and experienced, not too many people, at least the ones who come in new, not too many people pay attention to details. And that's why you make mistakes, whether it's in events or in travel. Otherwise, you wouldn't be losing passports, you wouldn't be losing tickets. And we wouldn't be messing up with sound systems or light systems or the video not working, or when you click something, that's not happening. So one needs a very good amount of passion and, of course, a lot of interest to actually get into detailing, into the depths of things. You cannot just say I'm an event manager without knowing how this microphone works. I got to know how to talk to a client, make my presentations, understand the technicalities also. And also, I'm in the space where we also do travel, because we were forced into it 8 years ago. That since you're doing events, you might as well do travel also. So we ended up doing tickets, visa, etc., and we learned along the way. So the bottom line is, I think we, whoever it may be, one can definitely join the industry, anyone can. But as long as one pays attention and gets into in-depth detailing, then everything will go right.
Fantastic. So, you know, as we talk about incentives and conferences and meetings, the other E that is very critical of MICE is the exhibition. So I think, Mr. Bharat, would you want to elaborate on the scope of exhibitions in MICE? Yeah.
Hello, everybody. Exhibitions is a very important part of business travel. And as you know, CII is one of the premier industrial organizations, and our main focus is to create value for the industry, for the Indian industry. And to create that value, we have promoted exhibitions all over the world. And I will take another cue from the first question that Tanuja you have asked. It is a very, very specialized sector. MICE may be of just four letters, but each letter is humongous, adds value separately to the whole terminology of MICE. It is a product that aims at creating a very large value in the tourism industry, because meetings, I for us is not incentive, but it is industry and inclusive growth along with our travel partners. So here we focus on meetings, conferences and events and exhibitions per se. So for that you need a lot of knowledge. The travel partner should have a lot of knowledge. He should learn what actually the client wants to achieve at the end. When it's incentive, obviously it's the dealers meet or the employee interactions. But when it's meetings, and conferences, we are aiming at the national level. We need to project. We need to brand India outside. We need to create value for our customers, which are the industries, which are our partners in India, our members. So hence, I'll say that it's
okay. To sum it up, sorry. So the MICE industry has been, you know, everyone has been eyeing this piece of pie in the tourism industry, and everybody today says that yeah, we do MICE. We have specialists in MICE here on the panel. The plus points and the negative aspects of this is that this is not a glamorous industry at all. There's a lot of hard work, as these people have put. One thing about MICE industry, and I don't know about what is lacking, which I feel, and I want your thoughts, is the best practices. Do you think there are best practices and ethical practices in MICE? Because we are here not having a product. We don't have a brochure, right? We customize it to our client's needs. We don't have any experience to give until the client, and we don't cater to one client or one family, right? We're talking about 200 people up to 2,000 people. So what are the challenges that we've kind of come across on managing such large scale incentive programs? Anybody who wants to take this question specific? Arun?
Yeah, as you partly put it across, a corporate decision maker takes a call on behalf of those 200 or 2,000 people. Many times it has happened, the requirement of all the 200, 2,000 people cannot be carried. So the corporate looks at it from the commercial angle or the purpose for which he's taking that particular purpose. So there's a whole lot of competition and more corporate, because MICE business is increasing, particularly the incentive type of business. So because of, as we know, the airline discounting, various issues, is not beneficial to tour or travel operator. So more and more people are getting into MICE. So the competition is very severe. The corporate also calls for each and every MICE group that he is going to take a decision, half a dozen to 10 to 12 operators. Among them, he will take a call. So at the end, the commercial factor becomes important than the real quality or the service that you would like to give. I may have excellent experience and knowledge of, a long-haul destination or even Phuket. I want to create it according to the RFQ what I receive. But that RFQ goes to a corner. At the end, we would like to have Bangkok done in 25,000 or 28,000 when already the airfare is in excess of 25.
Yeah, yeah. So, but you do have people who do this. So then how do you cater to that? Naveen?
I think undercutting is a big challenge.
Exactly.
And some companies, for the sake of getting into this business or for the sake of getting a group for a particular time period, try to get the business at the price, like Arun rightly said, which is practically not possible. Sometimes we have come across a situation when somebody has picked up the group and later on refused to operate, and then the client comes back to you and says, would you be able to do it? Now that's a very challenging situation in the business. I think selling is not about discounting. Selling is about providing a kind of an experience, what you can offer when you operate a particular movement. I think if we understand this aspect and try to give them some wow factor, which is practically possible, I think we can overcome a lot.
But it would depend if everyone else follows the same thought process. No?
I mean,
so basically, do you think that in our industry, there should be something like a standard practice, SOP, that all the people who are bidding for should get into? Maybe like a cartel, maybe like...
Then you have the other division, the government department to bang you down. But otherwise, seriously, according to me, see, like as RFPs and all go, I mean, I've also noticed that, let's say, there are companies that pick up groups at no profit, no loss, hoping to make up along the way. I mean, I don't think that's a nice way of doing business. At the end of the day, what's the point of starting business with your back already to the wall? I mean, you should be able to explain to the clients properly, make them, I mean, maybe, see, the client is sitting up here, very nice. He makes all, now in this case, all the mice play around, you know, with the cat. As you said, bell the cat. But why fight amongst each other? That's what I see. I'm not a professional from the travel industry, but I've just been into it for the last 8 years. But I think this cat fight or cat and mouse thing is not helping your industry, yes, in the sense.
Yeah.
I'm the only event manager. I've been hearing from morning all travel business here. But we're from the event side, and we also hope at times, you know, that the travel industry understands how the event industry works so that one can work together also.
Mr. Bharat, exhibition is a different space altogether. You just said that you need to create a brand India outside. We're talking about outbound mice here. So, I mean, what kind of mice then do you do as a organization, as a you're not you cannot be categorized as a travel agent, right? You are an organization in yourself. You probably take help of people like a Naveen or a Deepak to get this. So in a way you are also the client. So yeah, so basically what do you perceive about this whole game, and what can change this?
We are in a very different situation. I am a client, and I also am a service provider. I am a client to my travel partners, and we are service providers to our huge membership. And we have to cater to each and to a varied lot of people whom with we have a membership base, and we have to satisfy to the aspirations of each and everybody. So here we have to be transparent, our costs have to be minimum, and we have to show a way that whatever they are investing with us in a destination by participating in the exhibition gets them in some form back to them.
So see, the client speaks here, Naveen. So, I want cheap and the best. So,
but at the same time, we have to do a lot of research. So once an exhibition or a meeting or a conferencing destination is identified, we take it on me and my team, we first have to do a research as to what we are looking. So my first question is venue. What is the venue? When we see the venue, then we see, okay, what is the shortest and the cheapest mode of transferring my people from India into that country? So now we have the airlines, we need put in place the venue. So I have to now look for the accommodation. So we'll see how best we can put people in a decent hotel, in a place where I can minimize my cost of travel, or my cost of travel from airport to the hotel, or from hotel to the venue.
So you do this all yourself, or you still need somebody to take care of this? Somebody who's sitting on your left, right, whoever.
I have, I'm again going back to the question you asked. Mice is specialized. It is very specialized, and this is what we aim to deliver to our clients. So hence, most of the tasks I have tried with various people, but none of them has yet catered 100% delivered 100% satisfaction.
Okay, I'll give him a card after this. Okay, the next question probably is, you know, more about mice today. Most of the corporates are getting into a practice of an e-bid. Okay, now I see this, it's my personal opinion, is it a best practice or is it gambling?
No, it's a worst practice.
It's a worst practice.
So, I mean, is there any way? Do you participate in EBITS?
No, since you asked this question, let me give you an answer. Why it is a worst practice? One of the very top multinational bank, which believes in getting most of their quotes on EBIT, had invited 4 to 5 vendors, and the fifth vendor was they themselves.
Yeah, that's usually because, the case. That's usually
because
the case.
They had a budget of 35,000 to go to X destination. And we know, do whatever you want, even in minus, you cannot do that destination in 35. So what he will do is, he will go below 35 and put an entry as against the other four people.
That's usually the case.
Yeah.
That's usually the case. So the question is, what should we as MICE experts sitting on this panel and addressing an industry whose, there are some aspiring MICE entrants in this trade because something hasn't worked out for them. They know particular corporate. So what is the take on this? I mean, what should be the solution?
Yeah,
should we go for the bidding or should we kind of...
No, you should say no to
say
that
no
bidding.
No.
We have refused so many of those bids. See, let me tell you, year on year, there's a lot of growth happening in MICE business. And no individual tour operator or a vendor can handle more than 7 to 8 groups in a month, no matter how big your company or staff is. Tomorrow, imagine I'm getting 10 to 12 groups to handle. Can I? I cannot. So if we all gang together, I mean, whatever.
Yeah, I mean, we are not talking about a cartel is a bad word, maybe. MICE mafia is a nice word, better word. But instead of an association, what if we all
in a smallest way, Tanuja, I would like to ask, how many of us have the guts of saying no to a corporate when the business comes to me?
I think all of us sitting on this panel do that. So,
see, because that is one of the strengths when we exhibit that particular corporate will accept what you say. The moment I have
challenges, when you say no, there is somebody else who will pick
no
it up.
No problem. No problem. How many times? Now I have done that. In my all my previous organization, the other company who picked it up end up with a major loss because we are all in the same industry. We know how much a airfare costs or the hotel costs.
Absolutely.
If something is not possible in 35,000, you are going to refuse. Somebody else does it, he will do it at a loss. Once, twice, thrice. Why do you think there are so many other companies who are in MICE have closed down
so
MICE today?
So then why do you think so many players are aspiring to be in our shoes? I mean, why do they want to do MICE? Is MICE...
No,
does
one
it give
of the,
lot of money? Does it give lot of bottom line?
One of the reason is the airline discounts which have evaporated.
Where are they? Okay.
Okay. So because of that, everybody feels if you do MICE, I can earn more. But they come into MICE and do the same ticketing kind of practice. And nobody has the nerves of standing up to the corporate and refusing business. They are going around giving a hell of a lot of credit and various means. Ultimately, after 1 year, after 2 years, they themselves will learn, burn their hands, and they close down their divisions.
Mr. Deepak?
I mean, I just wanted to say that most of the times, again, from the travel industry part of it, you already know, let's say there's an particular client, and you already know that there are 5 of you who are empaneled in that company. You already know that all of you are going to bid with each other. Sometimes exchange notes. You know, sometimes. I mean, no, everybody at the end of the day wants to take that piece of business. I'll say, hello, I'm not quoting this much. Why do you all do that up and down? In some way, I mean, though here you're the client, I'm just saying, maybe it's wrong, but maybe we should educate the client also. You know, he can't just sit there and
I
just
get
say,
your point. It doesn't happen only in the travel space. It also happens in the event space. You are well aware of it because today, actually, at the end of it, if you see, and I don't know if you will agree, it's the corporate who's actually watching the nice big circus.
Yes.
So I think what should be the way forward is what we are here.
Yes.
As in a thought process.
In events, it's a lot different, please. It's not only the cost factor. Please don't forget that in events, the concept also works a lot.
Yeah.
You know, you want to go to Thailand, there is XYZ things you can do, that's about it. But if I go to Thailand, I can create something else altogether for them. So the concept also helps in winning the bid. It's not only the price factor.
Correct. Now, since he mentioned Thailand, the top 10 MICE destinations from India, I skipped a presentation, which is fine. The top 10 MICE destinations from India have always been the typical Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore, Dubai, Istanbul. Do you think by reinventing newer destinations, you're going to get a notch higher?
We've done events in 32 countries so far. Yes.
So which are the new destinations you think you would want to do events in and which you can sell to the corporate?
In terms of new destinations now, actually there's hardly anything left. I mean, if you go to a Croatia, there's not much you can do, though it's a fantastic place to go as a holiday. Yes, but you've done your Prague, you've done your Vienna's, Paris, everything. I mean, east, west, north, south, the other South America, and all, too far destinations to travel. So, I mean, it just depends.
But isn't that the future of MICE? What do you think, Mr. Bharat? Would you like to take your exhibition to Argentina?
In fact, you will be glad to know that we have already done an exhibition in Argentina, Sao Paulo, Panama, and probably next one is in Port of Spain. And you won't believe that there is the maximum response from my membership for these untapped markets.
So why aren't we reinventing ourselves, Arun, Naveen?
No, I agree with him. Because more and more corporate, as I'm telling you, the MICE business is increasing. People have traveled to all these destinations. They want to go to a new destination. So we ourselves have done events in places like Slovenia, Slovakia, and Bulgaria, and all that, which are not even heard of, and which airline goes there also many people don't know. And these are all emerging markets, so let's put it that way.
I second what Bharat said, that when you have these offbeat destinations, which are not like regular Thailand or Hong Kong or Malaysia, the response is pretty good. And like we have done events in places like Croatia and all these places, when you offer them, they feel, yeah, this is something different to go, because you can't go on routine to those destinations. Mm-hmm. Like destination like Iceland is very interesting, for example, to have.
Yeah, but it takes 18 hours to get there.
See, sometimes like what he rightly said, going to Argentina is even more. But it all depends, like if you have an interest and if you have a product to offer, like I second him also what he said it, that it's all about the concept. Like for MICE is more about the concept rather than booking a hotel and the air ticket.
Exactly.
So if you offer this kind of a services, client will definitely travel and you will have more participation.
Yeah, that's nice. And the last question I actually have for the panel, I wish there were more people here so that we could discuss it. Do you think at the end of it we are funding corporate's travel incentive? Because you know when you're buying a cruise or you're taking a holiday, you pay upfront and go. And the MICE business is getting more difficult by the day. Do you think we are actually funding it in a way?
Yes, we are.
Yes, totally.
Okay, so what is the way forward? I mean, again, I come back to my same question, like it's not about associations. I think everybody who have been in these sessions, what we have realized is there is a big gap. We don't sit, we don't talk, we meet each other in trade fairs, we meet each other in clients' offices. But I think there's a need of the RS to kind of get together and actually decide. You know, many hotels do this internationally. I've experienced this in Zurich. If there's a conference happening in Zurich, they maintain a rate parity. Do you think we should bring that to MICE today? Isn't that the need of the hour? Would you agree with me? Or would you disagree? Naveen is like shaking his head and...
Your question is about rate parity or about
rate parity and credit practices. It's like, I mean, if we all decide that no, there's no credit, so then what happens?
Like again, what we have said earlier, if we say no, somebody will do it.
Say yes.
That's a very unfortunate part.
But there are only few people who are empaneled. Let's talk about some big corporates.
Within the same empanelment.
Same empanelment.
Yeah, out of the four also, somebody will still take it.
So the need of the hour is for us to be strong and be together. Isn't it possible to coexist in the same space rather than... I know I'm being a very positive person, but... Yes, please, Vikas.
And it goes specifically on the world environment of dream. As you are termed as number one travel company in the world, I want to find out, like, how do you manage, or how would you manage the world events which dream almost monopolizes? So you are like, you'll manage World Cup, FIFA. What is there in the the leadership perspective in the coming 3 years' time, which are the absolute path-breaking thing to is doing?
See, as far as managing the global events, as some events like what you have mentioned about like cricket, for example, like TUI had the global rights till 2015. So whenever there's an ICC tournament, whether it is happening currently, like a Champions Trophy, or the 2020 World Cup, or a 50-50 over World Cup, yes, we have that product with us, and we appoint sub-agents further in the respective countries to sell those products. This is typically sports business which we do. As far as the conferencing is concerned, which are international events, which we are associated, what we try to do, we try to rotate them in different parts of the world, especially with some international events, which like happening in Barcelona, we try to bring them for the country like India. It can happen in Mumbai, for example, or Delhi. So those are the certain initiatives and the steps we take to rotate those international conferences or an event for the better understanding and to reach to the different parts of the world. Like if today we do it in India, tomorrow we would like to take it to Singapore, the same event, and we have done it successfully in the past. Certain international congresses which we have done in Europe, in Barcelona, we are able to do it in Singapore, then in India, and then now in Korea. So we have few examples of that.
Can I continue on this question? Would you be managing FIFA?
No, TUI is not managing FIFA.
Not
cricket is something which we
some
manage.
Good news.
FIFA is a different different ball game altogether.
So you manage the World Cup?
World Cup, the cricket.
No, my question was to, in this case, to the gentleman sitting next to you. In this case, would you buy from TUI?
They buy, people buy.
Yes, we do.
You know what?
Yeah.
We would buy from TUI because TUI would sell it to us, because when they are unable to sell the tickets.
My question then goes to Bharat. But if you have a government organized international meet during the World Cup, which rotate around, you know, a cricket diplomacy, and you manage a lot of this government movements of mice, which could be from 3 people to 3,000 people into a country. There is a cricket diplomacy going on. Would you buy from them?
No.
No?
No.
So what would you do in that case?
I mean, it's a hypothetical question. Yeah. It's a nice question.
There's a small company who's also managing government or a corporate body or something, which doesn't want to buy from TUI in some part of India. Would they come to you for help?
Yes, they do. See, we are not a corporate, and we are not working for profit, and we are all about promotion of trade and bilateral relationship amongst the two countries. Definitely, governments within in India and a few MOU partners, we are like us in their own countries, recognize us very strongly, and we cherish their memberships. With us and the relationship, and similarly we also represent ourselves to the government, because we are not commercializing that event. We are at one time we did have some plans that we should use cricket side by side for our business promotion of business activities in Australia and countries where people are not very easily, it's not very easily accessible destinations. That's not yet matured. But what happens is we also approach our MOUs in the other countries if some kind of event like the World Cup and things are happening. And we will try to use their contacts with the government and try to see if we can pull out something out of that.
I'm very sorry you're pulling these questions
out. Yeah, but
I worked for 20 years in the MICE environment. So, taking CIA into consideration, on or for behalf of industry here, which is sitting here, how can we benefit, how can India benefit in the travel sphere on the outbound perspective with CII?
I mean, he said that we do this all ourselves, so.
See, that's,
he just
see,
said
this
that.
Is where.
See, we have with us, let's say, OTOI with us, which is representing a large amount of, you know, travel outbound fraternity. We have some very good people who are here who are spending a lot of money promoting destinations, advertisement is spent and all. But we have a ready body, which is like CII. So many different verticals of the world, of India, sorry, of industries seek your help, and you give them solutions, and you take them all over the world, you do a lot of things. How can travel trade also benefit out of
that? See, travel trade is benefiting. I think I missed the last point, that when I do all this homework, I finally search for the correct travel partner which can further add value to what I have done. And we are not doing that, we are buying the tickets from the airlines directly or buying the hotel from the hoteliers directly. Yes, we do deal with them directly so that there is a fair amount of transparency. And whichever travel agency can act, because every travel agent, I believe, have their own areas and own destinations with which in which they expertise. And they have a more knowledge than what they might have in another area. So we also go out in the market and scout for that right travel partner who can add value to what we have already done. And then it's from there he takes it off. And,
so
and that's
know,
from where the...
The right travel partner. So that right is a question mark. Because I think, I don't know, we must be having...
Tanuja, can I
yes, sir.
Ask one small question or solution to Mr. Jain?
Yeah.
And this is fundamental to the incentive part of your MICE.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know how many people practice this good practice, which is very prevalent in the US or European market, for example. Typically what happens is a so-called MICE operator comes into play when the customer has already decided 25 passengers, Thailand, 35,000. Now, but I think the very wrong strategy to be
absolutely
partnering with anyone, including a CIF. Typically what I would do is to partner with you the entire incentive travel cycle, which means sitting with you at the planning stage when you're planning your incentive for the entire team for that year. First step. Second step is program finalization. Third step is program rollout. Fourth is venue selection. Fifth is pre-trip. Sixth is the trip itself. Seventh is post-trip, and then planning stage starts. If you're involved in all those stages, your chances of success is far higher than being just one of those four key bidders.
To take this question before the panel, I would also like to add to this, Gopi, that's the ideal scenario. Used to happen up to 2 years back, since I've been in MICE for a longer period of time now. Doesn't happen anymore, because today the scenario is that...
I beg to disagree, that's so, because I already have relationship with clients where
we do
I
that.
Do everything. Yeah.
We do that. So there are only far and few left, which probably you could count on your fingers. It's a relationship thing. But like he said, like for example, if he's the client, he says that he's decided everything and he just wants executioners. So I think today the corporates are more and more thinking of us as MICE executioners rather than MICE planners. And therein lies the real problem. And that is where we need to find a solution. So Arun, your take on this? Like he said, that 35,000 has been pre-decided, a destination has been pre-decided.
See, this, I'm sorry to interrupt. Here, are we talking about the costs?
We are talking about the whole process of an incentive.
Yeah. I'm talking about the entire cycle, yeah, which is involved right from planning stage.
Right.
Even before you decide the venue, because a potential partner can help you with a variety of venues, for example. You don't need to reinvent the wheel. For example, I would rather save Mr. Bharat Jain's time than doing the research when you have a credible partner who can do it for you.
No, I agree with him, because what he's saying, like if most of the time when we get into any business agreement, we would rather like to have it in the stage when they just have something in their mind which they wanted to discuss something. They said approximate budgets are like this, preferred destinations can be like this. We would like to be engaged at that stage, because there where you can show your expertise is all about. Because if somebody already have a predefined mindset, it is sometimes very difficult to change. And then the challenge comes, because somebody has thought of, like Tanuja said, of 35,000 rupees as a package cost, and which is practically not possible. So sometimes it's important to let it go, that kind of a business, rather than getting into those kind of businesses.
Naveen, thank you for that. Any audience questions? Because I think we are running out of time. Yes, ma'am.
I'm speaking about hotels, and I think hotels are a key element in any MICE.
Yeah.
We found for Fairmont Raffles and Swiss Hotel, we set up a global sales office, and we started off by saying we'll do a bit of MICE. And we have found that MICE is the big revenue generator, and there's a lot of business coming here. I just want to ask, is there merit, do you think there is merit in partnering with the travel company and going to the corporate with the travel partner to understand what the corporate is actually wanting? Because what often happens is that we are asked for a quote, we give a price, and there's a lot of back and forth, and somewhere in between, if we have the understanding in the beginning, we would like to see if that, you know, that could work better for us.
Some MICE planners do that. I mean, definitely, they do that. People, I have done myself for Fairmont Jaipur once. I think Naveen does that as well. And Naveen, would you want to answer that?
Yeah, I agree with Tekla, because I was on the both the sides. I was a hotelier and in travel business both. And I totally agree with her. It works, because if you have a person from a hotel who can explain her or his product, because the person is dealing in that in and out. So especially for the larger movement, especially if it is the conferencing movement, and you have a lot of detailing required for an event, for example, it is good to have a partner, a person who's from the venue or from the hotel, to be with you. Not for the small incentives where the detailing is required, which is very limited in nature, but of course for the good event or a conference, it works well.
Yeah, any last question? Any question? Vicky?
So Tanuja, I'll have to interrupt here. We have to give this all out. So we've got really, run out of time. And yeah, I know it's interrupting.
Thank you so much, all of you.
Thank you.
And sorry, Vicky, your question remains. We'll answer it later. So yeah, that's it. Vishal, over to you.
Yeah, thank you very much, Tanuja. And if you could, please, extend a token of participation.
Thank you for listening to us, all of us. A pleasure meeting all of you. Thanks.
Thank you.
Okay, all right.